This video is on Kruskal's minimum spanning tree algorithm. It has a few basic prerequisites and two more advanced ones. You should know how to sort, or at least be able to call a sorting routine, and you need to know what graphs are and how they're represented. It also uses the disjoint set data structure. Finally, it absolutely relies on the introductory video from the minimum spanning tree playlist. It picks off right where that one finished, starting now. We want to find minimum spanning tree edges to merge trees in our spanning forest. And Kruskal's strategy will be to consider the edges with the smallest weights first. In fact, we'll start by sorting all edges by weight, lowest to highest. Here, I just picked integer edge weights starting from 1 to make it easy to see their order, but they can be anything. To simplify my proofs, I assume edge weights are distinct, but the algorithm works regardless. We consider edges in order, lightest edge first, and for each, we determine if it's in the minimum spanning tree or not, right then and there. We never wait or change our mind later. In the animation, edges we haven't looked at yet are blue, minimum spanning tree edges are red, and discarded edges will be faint. When we consider edge 5, do we add it to the minimum spanning tree? The edge connects vertices B and C. If those two vertices are in different trees of the growing forest, the edge gets added to the minimum spanning tree. Otherwise, it's discarded. In this case, it gets added, but we should justify that. Consider either of the trees it connects, say CGD. The claim is that edge 5 is the minimum weight edge crossing the cut from that tree to the rest of the graph. Why? We've already considered all edges with lower weight. At this instant in time, any edge ever added to the forest obviously has both of its vertices in the same tree. And that would be true for any edge we discarded too. It was discarded because its vertices were already in the same tree. So every edge in the graph, lighter than this one, goes between two vertices previously merged into the same tree. This edge is the lightest of all edges between any of the different trees, so it's the lightest edge leaving the CGD tree. The lightest edge leaving any tree crosses the cut between the tree and the rest of the graph, so by the cut crossing theorem in the introduction video, it's in the minimum spanning tree. How about when we get to edge 6 and it connects two edges already in the same forest tree? How do we justify discarding it? C and D are already connected by edges previously added to the forest, and we're taking edges in increasing order, so all of those previous edges weigh less than this one. So this edge has the maximum weight in a cycle from the graph, and the cycle theorem from the introduction video tells us this edge definitely isn't in the minimum spanning tree, so we can discard it. Great. We have the outline of the algorithm and proof that it will find the minimum spanning tree, but we left out the detail of how we determine whether or not the vertices of an edge are from the same forest tree or not. We could search the forest, starting from one of the vertices, to see if we get to the other, but that's kind of slow. Instead, we'll try to track trees as they merge as efficiently as possible. Each vertex starts out in its own little tree. You check to see if two vertices are in the same tree or not, and if they aren't, you add an edge to merge two trees into a bigger one. This is the perfect situation for the disjoint set data structure. Each vertex starts out in its own set. Two vertices are in the same tree if they're in the same set. Check if they have the same representative. If not, add the edge to the minimum spanning tree. Take the union of those two sets that capture that the trees have been merged. My version of union returns true if it combines two separate sets. I'll actually use that to check if vertices are from the same set. So that's the algorithm, and I'll start the animation again from the beginning, but I'll add the underlying disjoint set structure that's used to determine which vertices are in the same tree. Notice, you might implement this by having the same object serving as both a vertex in your graph and a vertex in the disjoint set, so that you have direct access to the disjoint set vertex. But the edges from the disjoint set are not from the graph. Right now, J is a child of D, but JD isn't a graph edge. Even if they share actual vertex objects, these are two separate data structures. We could stop once we know we've added V-1 edges, or not. When we finish, we should check that we have V-1 edges. If we don't, the graph wasn't connected to begin with. How long does it take? Well, that disjoint set data structure is only marginally superlinear, so sorting edges by weight will dominate our runtime with a general sort. If you have special edge weights that you can sort in linear time, the disjoint set operations dominate your runtime. For all practical purposes, that's linear. Anyway, that's it for this one. Now I'm going to go wax my mustache with whatever I can find in my ears.